Hi and welcome. In this video, I will discuss various concepts related to cloud computing, including its characteristics, its service models and deployment models, and various security issues related to cloud computing. Before moving further, please turn on the subtitles for this video. And do subscribe my channel for similar videos. Now in cloud computing, the storage and the processing is not performed locally on the system, rather it is performed over the network. Therefore, cloud computing is also known as internet-based computing or remote virtualization, because the actual hardware or infrastructure is virtualized from the user. So computing is performed in the cloud, therefore the complexity of this computing is isolated from the user. Now in cloud computing, the cloud service provider or CSP provides a shared pool of storage, networking and processing resources. And this is also known as resource pooling. So there are two layers of these shared pool of resources. That is, first layer is the physical or hardware layer, that is the network devices or the physical servers or physical storage devices. Then upon this physical layer, there is a layer of abstraction for manifestation of this cloud application to the user or to the cloud service provider. So there is minimum management overheads on the user, and this cloud infrastructure is being managed by the cloud service provider, and user has no direct interaction or involvement with the physical hardware. So this infrastructure remains transparent to the user. Now this cloud supports or is compatible with broad range of heterogeneous devices, for example your desktops, your laptops and your mobile phones. Now cloud service provider manages the data centers which are distributed, and these data centers are available anywhere on the network or over the internet. So the functions provided by these data centers are distributed geographically using the edge server, and this edge server is also an important concept with regards to content distribution or content delivery networks, where the user is provided services with the server from the server which is located geographically near its location. Now cloud provides services to multi-tenants, that is multiple customers, and one characteristic of cloud is the rapid provisioning of these services to the user as per the demand of the user, and this demand is scalable. And cloud also provides elasticity. It means that you can shut down a hardware if it is no longer required, and then you can turn it on when it is required. And cloud computing also supports self-service. It means that the customer can provide resources or allocate resources to itself without the interaction of the cloud service provider. So cloud also provide metered services or metered services. It means that you pay as per your use of the cloud resources, and these metered or metered services are monitored and reported for transparency and optimization, and this report is available for the user and also for the cloud service provider. Now there are certain issues with the cloud computing, and first issue, which is the most important issue, is the data privacy, that is the data of the user. And what user can do is it can perform pre-encryption of its data before putting it on over the cloud. And another aspect is the compliance to the local policy or the local regulations. So before using the cloud service provider, any organization may investigate the cloud service provider for the compliance to the organization policies or to the local laws. And another concern is related to the geographical location of actual cloud hardware, which is in the control of a third party. So the user organization may perform stringent service level agreements and other contracts with the cloud service provider. And another concern is the network connectivity, which is must for using the cloud service provider services. And another aspect is the limited customization, which is available for the user. So in contracts, the user organization may define the responsibility metrics, dividing the responsibilities between user organization and the cloud service provider. And another aspect or concern is the virtual machine escape or VM escape, because this cloud is actually advanced form of virtualization. Therefore, any virtual machine, if it gets compromised, and this compromise may lead to compromise of other machines. Another concern is that the cloud service provider may go out of business. And another concept is regarding the disaster recovery mechanisms employed by the cloud service provider. Now, coming over to the service models, so there are basically three service models, and these service models are the software as a service, where and second one is the platform as a service, and third one is the infrastructure as a service. Now, in software as a service, the user has minimum control and therefore minimum operations headovers. And then in platform as a service, the user has more control over the cloud and therefore more overheads. And in infrastructure as a service, the user has maximum control over the cloud infrastructure and therefore maximum overheads. So an example of a software as a service or SaaS is that the user may use the application which is being provided by the cloud service provider. So user is only the user of this application. And related terminologies related to this software as a service is the security as a service, where the security is provided as software only security by the cloud service provider. For example, the vulnerability testing, penetration testing, antivirus services. And another related concept is the cloud access security broker, which is basically a policy enforcer between cloud service provider and the user organization. Now, the second model is the platform as a service. An example of this platform as a service is that you are provided with a platform to deploy a specific application. And third is the infrastructure as a service, where you can deploy any operating system or any application. Now, there are four deployment models. That is the private cloud, which is a dedicated cloud for single organization. And then is the community cloud, which is the cloud for similar stakeholders. And then is the public cloud, which is open for all. And then is the hybrid cloud, which is combinations of all three above deployment models. Now, first of all, I will go further into the details of the service models. So once we talk about software as a service, then this software as a service, the user has to just use the application which is provided by the cloud service provider, and user has only control over the user specific configuration of this application. For example, you this application can be accessible from thin client interface, for example your web browser, and using this web browser you are accessing this application, for example an email application provided by the Gmail or any other program interface. So there is no licensing cost or other operational or hardware cost for the user, but there is a subscription cost for using this application. So there is more subscription cost and less operational and maintenance or upfront cost. Now in platform as a service, the operating systems and programming tools are provided by a cloud service provider, and user just has to use this software stack and to deploy its own application. So user can just deploy its application. Then third is the infrastructure as a service. So in infrastructure as a service, the virtualized infrastructure in shape of processing, virtual servers and memory and storage is provided to the user, and also the network, but the actual hardware is never provided to the user. So actual hardware still remains the responsibility of cloud service provider. So once we talk about the further details of this deployment models, then in private cloud, it is deployed for single organization, and it may be operated by this organization, or it may be operated by the third party, or it may be located on the premises of the user organization, and it may be located off the premises and on the premises of the cloud service provider. So once it is located on the premises of the organization, then organization has more control, but it has more operational and maintenance overheads and more upfront cost of hardware and licensing cost, but there is no subscription cost. And once it is located off the premises of the user organization, but on the premises of the cloud service provider, then all the upfront cost and hardware cost and other licensing cost is bear by the cloud service provider, and the user is only responsible for subscription cost, that is monthly. Now, once we talk about community cloud, so organization with similar or shared concern or shared policy or security concern can deploy this community cloud, and it may be operated by the any member of this community, or it may be operated by the third party, and it may be located on the premises of any of the community or any of the organization in the community, or it may be located on the premises of third party or on the premises of cloud service provider. Third deployment model is the public cloud, which is all open cloud for use of everyone on the maybe on the internet, and it may be owned by the any business or many academia or government, and it is however located only on the premises of the cloud service provider. And third model is the hybrid model, which is combinations of all above deployment model, that is private cloud, community cloud and public cloud. So in this hybrid cloud, the private cloud operate in a distinct manner as a distinct entity from the maybe from the public cloud. For example, you are using private cloud for certain critical services, and you are using the public cloud for less critical services, or maybe you are using the private cloud and once the load is more on the cloud, then you are shifted to the public cloud, and this is also called load cloud bursting, where you shift the load of the cloud services to maybe the public cloud or other cloud deployment model. So this is all from my side. Please stay connected to this channel for similar videos. Thank you.